غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذو الطول لا إله إلا هو وإليه المصير. اللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى، ولك الحمد إذا رضيت، ولك الحمد على حمدنا إياك يا رب العالمين. My dear brothers and sisters, I began by praising Allah Azza wa Jal, the one whom we praise and the one whom we ask for help and forgiveness. And I seek refuge by Allah from the evil of myself and the evil of my deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides, none would be able to misguide. And whomsoever Allah allow to be misguided, none would be able to guide. And I praised Allah Azza wa Jal, the forgiver of the sins, the acceptor of the repentance, the severe in punishment. Nothing is comparable to Him. To Him we shall all return. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين تركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. And I bear witness that there is no deity worthy the worshipping except Allah, the One, the Sufficient Master. He begots not, nor He was begotten, and there is none co-equal, nor comparable unto Him. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last and the final messenger of Allah. He sent him to us with the message of Islam. And he struggled so hard and exercised jihad in the true meanings of jihad. To ensure that what we have today in our hands is the last and the final message from Allah. عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي المقصرة بتقوى الله وأحذركم ونفسي من عصيانه ومخالفة أمره لزوما لقوله الحق تبارك وتعالى في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وكذلك في قول الحق تبارك وتعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا اتقوا الله فإنه من لا يتق ربه فإن له معيشة ضنكا ويحشر يوم القيامة أعمى فيقول ربي لم حشرتني أعمى وقد كنت بصيرا فيقال كذلك أتتك آياتنا فنسيتها وكذلك اليوم تنسى. I began by encouraging you and myself first of all to fulfill the commands of Allah. And I warned you and myself first of all from disobeying Him. According to Him telling us in the Quran, O you who believe, fear Allah the way He should be feared and by not accepting the state of Islam. And for Him also telling us in the Quran, O mankind, fear your Lord, the one who created you from one soul and created its mate from it and created from them so many men and women. And fear your Lord, by whose name you demand your mutual rights from one another. And fear your Lord, by observing the right of your blood tie relatives, your rahim. Fear your Lord, as those who do not fear Allah would live a miserable life. And we'd be resurrected blind in the hereafter. And when they cry and complain, why are we resurrected blind when we used to see in our life? The answer comes to them that the ayat of Allah came on you and you ignored it. And that's why you will be ignored. My dear brothers and sisters, allow me in today's khutbah, in whatever permissible time, to share with you a topic that I have found that affects many of our lives. The issue of the unseen related to jinn and sihr has been an issue that is all the time brought to the attentions of imams. And there has been a lot of misperceptions and misunderstandings into how we should perceive this issue. Allah the Mighty have illustrated to us in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, the story of Adam alayhi salam.
وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ.
He illustrated to us that he have asked the malaika to make sujood of honor to Adam alayhi salam. And they all responded to the command of Allah except Iblis, أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ, refused and became from the kafirin, out of his arrogance. And in Surah Al-Kahf, Allah the Mighty illustrates for us. Allah on the other side, in Surah Al-Kahf, illustrates to us that Iblis, لَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ, was nothing but jinn. كَانَ مِنَ الْجِنِّ. And then also Allah Azza wa Jal in the Quran, in a chapter dedicated to describe jinn to us, in Surah Al-Jinn, Allah illustrates for us the entity of jinn. And they are creation of His, like ourselves. We're created from clay, they're created from fire. And they're also, as we are susceptible to guidance and misguidance, as we have an inclination to follow the guidance as well as to disobey Allah Azza wa Jal, is to be said about al-jinn. وَأَنَّ مِنَّا الصَّالِحُونَ وَمِنَّا دُونَ ذَلِكَ كُنَّا طَرَائِقَ قِدَدًا. As they have illustrated, as Allah Azza wa Jal illustrates to us in the Quran, that there are among them who are righteous and there are those who are unrighteous. And at the same time, Allah the Mighty illustrates for us, وَأَنَّا لَمَّا سَمِعْنَا الْهُدَىٰ آمَنَّا بِهِ فَمَنْ يُؤْمِن بِرَبِّهِ فَلَا يَخَافُ بَخْسًا وَلَا رَهَقًا. As Allah illustrates that when they heard the Huda, when they heard the Quran, as the Mufassirun illustrated, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was once resurgir when he was coming back from At-Taif, and the jinn heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam reciting the Quran. When they were roaming the earth as a result of them not being able to listen to the sky. وَأَنَّ لَمَسْنَا السَّمَاءَ فَوَجَدْنَاهَا مُلِئَتْ حَرَثًا شَدِيدًا وَشُهُبًا. As a result, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam bi'tha, before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam received the message, they used to from before listen to the malaika and get some of the news of the sky and tell it to those who deal with the jinn. And they were not able to do it anymore, and they were roaming the earth to find out why. And as a result, they heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam reciting the Quran. So there are those mu'mineen from the jinn, and there are the kafirin from the jinn, as Allah illustrates to us in the Quran. So the fact is that jinn does exist. We do not see it with our naked eye, but they are creation of Allah Azza wa Jal the Mighty. On the other side, Allah Azza wa Jal illustrates to us their power and ability in the Quran, how they do have a superpower that human might not claim. Allah Azza wa Jal the Mighty illustrates to us that indeed they have abilities and power that we might not as a human have. And Allah Azza wa Jalla created to Sulaiman alayhi salam the ability to use the jinn in a good way to build for him. It's to us that Sulaiman alayhi salam used the jinn and they built for him huge plates. And as I mentioned in one of the khutab, there is no contradiction into the scientific facts of nowadays and with the ability of the jinn. It could be that these huge plates that mentioned in the Quran, as some of us said, for feeding the people, but it could be also those dishes and satellite receivers that we have them right now built in huge diameters to be able to communicate with the satellites and facilitate communication on earth. And this is something known to us. And the pots, boilers, as it is illustrated in the Quran, could be the nuclear power planet that produces power for the king whom Allah Azza wa Jal have given the power to be able to rule earth at the time of Sulaiman alayhi salam. So there is no contradiction between the power and ability of the jinn and the scientific facts. As a matter of the fact, we know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have traveled from Mecca to Medina to the sky in a very short time. And at the same time, that's what mentioned to us in the Quran, how Sulaiman alayhi salam, Allah facilitated the wind for him to be able to travel a distance overnight that would be taking normally a month of time of a travel. And at the same time, Allah Azza wa Jal have also illustrated to us in the Quran that jinn, the kafara of jinn, do have the ability to exercise sihr, magic. And sihr in the Arabic language, if you go to the dictionaries and click on the meaning of sihr, you will find that it refers to any act that is done in secret and influences people around you. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Inna min al-bayan ila sihr." From the beauties, the power of the speeches is a miracle that influences and changes the perceptions of people. And the same is to be said about as-sahr, which is the time in which we have the suhoor. We eat in the darkness, and it's called sahar because it's done in the darkness and without being exposed and seen in the daylight. From that perspective, we do also believe that sihr does exist, as Allah the Mighty have also illustrated to us in the story of Musa alayhi salam with the magicians, when they said to him, "Ya Musa, imma an tulqiya wa imma an nakuna nahnu al-mulqin." Qala alqu. فَلَمَّا أَلْقُوا سَحَّرُوا أَعْيُنَ النَّاسِ وَاسْتَرْهَبُوهُمْ وَجَاءُوا بِسِحْرٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allah the Mighty illustrates for us that the magicians asked Musa alayhi salam, when they were too excited, when they were seeking the award from Fir'aun la'natullahi alayhi, when he promised them to give them awards if they were to compete with Musa alayhi salam. And he said to them, "Go ahead, show me what you have." And as Allah says, فَسَحَّرُوا أَعْيُنَ النَّاسِ, they fooled the eyes of people around them. وَاسْتَرْهَبُوهُمْ, and this is primarily the power of black magic. استرهبوهم in the Arabic language is an exaggerated form of rahba, fearing the people. And that's exactly the concept of magic and sihr. And as it is, it fools the eyes of people and it fears them and ruins their life from the perceptions that they build in their mind out of nothing. Sihr is nothing but fooling the eyes. فَسَحَّرُوا أَعْيُنَ النَّاسِ, fooling the people's eyes and changing their perceptions and create the fear into their hearts. And that's exactly what sihr is all about, as Allah the Mighty have illustrated it to us in the Quran. وَأَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ فَيَا فَوْزَ الْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ. Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nastahdihi wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa sayyiati a'malina man yahdihillahu fahuwa al-muhtadi wa man yudlil falan tajida lahu waliyan murshida. Yes, indeed, sihr does also exist, as do jinn exist, and at the same time, sihr is mentioned to us in the Quran as a fact that does exist in reality. The question comes here whether we're allowed as Muslimin to exercise sihr or not. And clearly, the Quran indicates that it is kufr wal-iyadu billah. وما كفر سليمان ولكن الشياطين كفروا يعلمون الناس السحر وما أنزل على الملكين ببابل هاروت وماروت وما يعلمان من أحد حتى يقولا إنما نحن فتنة فلا تكفر فيتعلمون منهما ما يفرقون به بين المرء وزوجه وما هم بضارين به من أحد إلا بإذن الله ويتعلمون ما يضرهم ولا ينفعهم ولقد علموا لمن اشتراه ما له في الآخرة من خلاق. Allah Azza wa Jal illustrates clearly to us as when he first moved to Medina and was speaking about Sulaiman alayhi salam as being prophet of Allah Azza wa Jal, the Bani Israel who were in Medina were making fun and saying Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam speaks about Sulaiman as a prophet, he was nothing but a magician, and Allah Azza wa Jal revealed this ayat to tell them that what you said is something should not be said about a prophet of Allah. He is a prophet of Allah, that Allah Azza had given him the kingdom and had given him the power, had given him things that he did not give to any other. And as a result, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam also illustrated to us that whoever goes to Arraf, whoever goes to a magician, whoever goes to someone that claims to predict the future, someone who predicts to know the unknown or the unseen, or to tell you what is wrong in your life, and to tell you how he can cure you from a sickness that you might physically or emotionally be suffering from, then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that لا تقبل له أعمال أربعين يوم, that the deeds of 40 days would not be accepted from you by only going to consult with them. What if you believed in them? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam had said clearly, فَقَدْ كَفَرَ بِمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ. If you go to a magician believing in their power and ability, then you have disbelieved in what has been revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So my brothers and sisters, the Quran is very clear, and this deen of Allah azza wa jal have come to serve the Bedouin lives in the desert, as well as serving individuals who are living in the most sophisticated societies on earth at all times. The Quran we have should be comprehended and should be beneficial to the one who is living in the jungles and to the one who is living in the West. Quran is Quran. He said that if we're not allowed to go to magicians for treatment, if someone have possessed us or have influenced us with black magic, and most of the times 99% of the cases that comes to my attentions are not sihr, are not black magic, it's only illusions into people's mind that they believe they're possessed with sihr. And we go to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and find out how we can, if there is any influence of jinn into our life or an influence of sihr into our life, how can we deal with it? And the best of everything, how can we protect ourselves from being harmed or influenced by the, generally speaking, anything that harms us in our life? As it is reported in one of the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that one of the Sahaba was coming back, and when he got home, he found his wife outside, and he got so outraged to see her not wearing hijab standing outside, and she told him to take it easy on himself and to go inside and in the bedroom. And when he walked into the bedroom, he found a huge snake on the bed, and immediately took his spear to kill the snake. They both got killed as a result of him trying to kill the snake, which was a jinn. And as a result, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that whenever we see from the snakes, the scorpions, those, you know, give them warning three times. Say, A'udhu billahi min shaitan rajim three times. Or say, leave the home three times. And if it's still there, then it's nothing but a snake or a scorpion. You can kill it or remove it. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam illustrated to us that there is nothing as powerful as the Quran. And let me conclude, inshallah, with this very famous hadith that we earlier time here about the ruqya shar'iyya, which is what we need to do to ourselves and to our beloved whom we think that they have something wrong in their life. And as I said again, I repeat, 99% of the cases that come to my attention were nothing but perceptions in people's mind. There is a beautiful hadith reported by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, which is reported in Sahih Bukhari, in which a group of Sahaba were traveling, among them Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, and they were stopping to rest in one of the towns. And then a young lady came to them and said, "Inna Sayyid al-Hayy Maldugh," that the master or the leader of this town was beaten by a scorpion. "Any of you is raq? Hal minkum min raq? Do anyone of you know how to treat?" Then Abu Sa'id al-Khudri himself stood up, and the Sahaba around him were extremely surprised because that he is able to do it. And he went, and as the hadith reports to us, he treated this man with al-Fatiha, with the Fatiha of the Kitab, and this is an authentic hadith. And then Allah Azza wa Jal recovered the man from the sickness he had by the power of the Fatiha, by the will of Allah Azza wa Jal the Mighty. And when he come back again to the Sahaba, they told him, "How did you know that this is a treatment?" And they said, that he was given something as a result of his work. And then they said, "We consult with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." And when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when they reported to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to them, "وَمَا يُدْرِيكُمْ أَنَّهَا رُقْيَةً." What made you believe that Al-Fatiha is ruqya, as a kind of endorsement that it is indeed a ruqya for anything? As Ibn Qayyim illustrated, that he once was in Mecca and he was so sick, and he used to recite the Fatiha only, times and times, on water of Zamzam, and drink it, and then by the will of Allah Azza wa Jal, he was recovered. Hadith clearly illustrates for us that this Sahabi
to be able to treat
this man who was sick by only the Fatiha, which means necessarily that you, ya Muslim, ya Muslima, is able to do it by yourself. This Sahabi never done it from before, but he had a strong belief in Allah Azza wa Jal, and that what have made him to be able to cure this man who was sick. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also illustrated in his authentic hadith, that whoever goes to visit a sick, nothing would take him to visit that sick except the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal, and recited the dua, "Humma rabban nas mudhib al-ba's ishfi wa anta ash-shafi shifaan la yughadiru saqama," 7 times, then by the will of Allah Azza wa Jal, this person will be recovered, except that he is destined to leave this dunya and death is prescribed on him. My brothers and sisters, let's be true believers in Allah Azza wa Jal. Let's be like the Sahaba who have demonstrated for us their faith and their true faith in Allah Azza wa Jal, that whoever is with Allah, Allah will be with them. And let's keep in mind also that we are not in this dunya created for entertainment. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدٍ. We created man in hardship. It could be that Allah Azza wa Jal is testing you with either physical sickness, as we see sometimes people are laying on beds in hospitals because of some physical sickness, and they seek the treatment. And it could be that Allah Azza wa Jal also is testing you with emotional sickness, with spiritual sickness, as it happened to the Sahabiyya who came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and said to him, "Ya Rasulullah, inni usra', I get seizures, and idu Allah li, pray to Allah Azza wa Jal to give me recovery." And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam could have made dua to her immediately, and she would be recovered because he is the Prophet of Allah and his dua is accepted. But he said to her the following, "In shi'ti da'awtu Allah laki," if you wish, I would pray to Allah Azza and he will recover you. "Wa in shi'ti tasburi wa laki al-jannah." Allahu Akbar. If you wish, you'll be patient and your award will be al-jannah. And when she said, what she said immediately is, "Ya Rasulullah, bal asbir wa ahtasib," I will seek refuge by Allah Azza wa Jal, I'll be patient. Because she knew whatever she's going through is nothing compared to the eternal life of the Akhirah. So let's be patient. Yes, sometimes we are depressed, sometimes we feel down, sometimes we do have emotional sickness that could be treated by the will of Allah Azza wa Jal, using the Book of Allah and using other techniques, the psychotherapy technique, which is based on the Deen of Allah Azza wa Jal and on the Quran, to help us be cured and recovered. And the best of everything for protection is to recite the Idhkar of Sabah and Al-Masa, the daily, morning and evening Idhkar, in which we connect with Allah Azza wa Jal. As the Prophet illustrated, whoever recites 10 verses from Surah Al-Baqarah, لا يقرب الشيطان بيته أبدا. Whoever recites 10 verses from Surah Al-Baqarah, no shaitan come to his home and come close to him. And the best of the ayat in Surah Al-Baqarah, the first 5, Alif Lam Mim, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب, and Ayat Al-Kursi, the following 2 ayah, and the last 2 ayah, as they are the very powerful ayat in the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. When you recite the Ayat Al-Kursi, no shaitan, nothing is to harm you in your day, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam illustrated to us. If you recite it after your salah, after each salah you pray to Allah, then you happen to die, you will be going to Al-Jannah, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam illustrated to us. Hadith also reported to us from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whoever walks out from home and say Bismillah, tawakkaltu ala Allah, wala hawla wala quwwata illa billah, these a few words, the malaika will be saying to you, kufita wa ufita wa uqita. The malaika will be saying to you, you have done enough, you are protected, and nothing is going to come across you ever, whatever it is, from the jinn or from the ins. And let's keep in mind that we have treasures in the Quran, al-mu'awwidhat. Those are very powerful ayat we can recite to ourselves and to our children. May Allah Azza wa Jal enable us to understand and comprehend the deen of Allah. Allahumma ameen. And may Allah Azza give us the sabr and patience and give shifa to those who are sick. Allahumma ameen. Inna Allahu malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina صلى عليه وسلم تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك اللهم على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم إن عبيدك أبناء عبيدك أبناء إمائك نواصين بيدك ماض فينا حكمك عدل فينا قضاؤك نسألك اللهم بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك بأن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا يا الله. اللهم اجعله جلاء لهمنا وأحزاننا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم رب الناس مذهب البأس اشفي وأنت الشافي شفاء لا يغادر سقما. اللهم رب الناس مذهب البأس اشفي وأنت الشافي شفاء لا يغادر سقما. اللهم رب الناس مذهب البأس اشفي وأنت الشافي شفاء لا يغادر سقما. اللهم اشفي جميع مرضى المسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم فرج كربنا وارحم ضعفنا وتولى أمرنا. اللهم إنا قد لجأنا إليك واحتمينا بك فاحفظنا واحفظ أبناءنا وأزواجنا فإنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم اغفر لوالدينا وارحمهما كما ربيانا صغيرا. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وأقم الصلاة.